Hello, I'm Jessica Williams, curator of history and collections at the Intrepid Museum. We're continuing our behind-the-scenes video series about flight operations on Intrepid. Today, we'll be talking about launching the plane. Intrepid may seem like a big ship. The flight deck is around 900 feet long, but compared to an airport, Intrepid has a much smaller runway. This means that pilots don't have much space to build up speed for takeoff.
Intrepid's two catapults helped airplanes reach takeoff speed. They pulled the airplane down the flight deck, helping it to get up to speed much faster than the airplane's own engines could. During World War II, Intrepid had hydraulic catapults, but by the 1950s, heavier jet aircraft required more force to reach takeoff speed. New steam catapults installed in the 1950s gave Intrepid the power to launch these new jets.
Behind me is the steam accumulator for one of Intrepid's two catapults. The ship's main boilers delivered high-pressure steam, which powered the catapult system. Intrepid's captain ordered the ship to point into the wind to give the airplane a little more lift for takeoff. The flight deck crew positioned the airplane at the end of the catapult track. They used a bridle to attach the airplane to the catapult shuttle.
When it was time to launch, the catapult officer released high-pressure steam into the catapult cylinder. Right before takeoff, the pilot powered the airplane's engines. Then, the catapult was fired. The piston shot down the catapult track, pulling the airplane, like this Vietnam-era Sky Raider, to takeoff speed. The airplane accelerated from 0 to 150 miles per hour in less than 2 seconds.
Intrepid's airplanes are now in the air. Next, we'll learn about coordinating the mission. Stay tuned for the next installment of Conducting a Mission.
Go to intrepidmuseum.org for more behind-the-scenes videos. And to learn more about Intrepid's involvement in the Vietnam War, be sure to check out our new exhibition, On the Line, Intrepid in the Vietnam War, now open.